礼拜五晚上的聚会。
Hallelujah, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, begin this evening's Sabbath service.
我们一起来唱诗148首。
Let us sing hymn number 148. Peace be with all the brothers and sisters.
感谢神的带领，让我们现在在这边一起开始所唱的安息圣日，然后来学习神的话语。
Really thank God for His guidance that we may all come gather to observe His Sabbath day and learn His truth.
尤其在这疫情当中。我们碰到很多的苦难，所以感谢神的带领，让我们在他里面能够得到平安。
Especially in the midst of this pandemic, we have endured quite a bit of tribulations, and therefore, in Him we shall receive peace.
我们现在就跪下祷告，求神带领我们今天晚上的聚会。
We shall all kneel down, pray together, and ask God to guide our service this evening.
奉主耶稣基督的名，在这边跟大家来一起来分享。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I come here to share with everyone.
今天晚上小弟跟大家分享的题目是在苦难中使人昌盛。
The topic like that I would like to speak on today would be God makes you prosperous in adversities.
我们在安定的社会的时候，原本就会面临许多的苦难。
Even in a time of stable societies, we will still encounter a lot of difficulties.
但是现在我们发生了疫情，在这个期间苦难会更增加。
However, in the midst of this pestilence, our tribulations and difficulties shall also increase.
很多人失去了工作，生活有问题。
Many people lost their jobs that they have difficulties.In their daily lives.
有的人生病或是精神忧郁的病的人就增加了。
And so those people who become physically ill or mentally ill also increase in numbers.
在家庭里面报章杂志上也讲到说有很多的暴力增加，醉酒的人也比较多，离婚率也增加了。
In the news, we see that there is an increase in the cases of domestic violences, alcohol abuse, as well as those who came to divorce.
我们许多人在这种苦难环境下，都对未来跟现在都失去了希望，心里非常的悲观。
Living in such difficult circumstances, we lose hope of the future and we become quite pessimistic.
所以往往会觉得人生的尽头都到了。
And so quite often we consider the end of lives is near.
但是我们信神的人，我们从圣经里面要来寻求神的话语。
Nonetheless, as believers of God, we shall come to seek His words within the Bible.
我们在圣经里面就可以看到记载许多人在苦难当中，神使他们非常的昌盛。
We can read in the Bible that for a lot of people, God had made them very prosperous even in the time of adversities.
我们首先来看看古圣徒约瑟，他在苦难中，神让他得到昌盛。
We can also read how, for Joseph, an ancient saint, for whom the Lord made him.Prosperous in a time of adversity.
约瑟的苦难从17岁开始，一直延续到他30岁。
Joseph's adversity actually started when he was 17 all the way until he was in his 40s.
他首先的苦难就是在17岁的时候被他的哥哥们出卖给以实玛利的商人。
When he was 17 years old, he was sold by his brothers onto the hands of those Ishmael, Ishmael people.
我们看创世纪的第三十七章第二十八节。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 37.
Please read.
Verse 38. Then Midianite traders passed by, so the brothers pulled Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit and sold him to the Ishmaelites for 20 shekels of silver, and they took Joseph to Egypt. So Joseph was originally the favorite son of his, of their father in the household.
他的父亲特别给他做一件彩衣，这样的话，哥哥们就很痛恨他。
And the father actually made a rainbow color cloth for Joseph, and therefore it brought a lot of ire from his brothers.
也是又做了两个梦，哥哥们听到这个梦以后，哥哥们就更加的嫉妒他。
And Joseph even had two dreams that upon description of these two dreams, Joseph's brothers became quite jealous of him.
所以当约瑟到旷野找他哥哥们的时候，他哥哥们就设计要谋害他，所以最后就把他卖给以斯玛利人当奴隶。
As such, when Joseph went to the wilderness to seek out his brothers, the brothers conspired against Joseph to sell him to the Ishmaelites.
我们可以想象，约瑟当时一定是非常的哀伤，没有想到他自己现在会落到这样悲惨的地步。
We can imagine how sorrowful Joseph was that he never imagined himself to be in such a situation.
所以就这样子，约瑟就被带到埃及，然后一个埃及人波提凡就把他买下来，在家里当他的奴隶。
Because of that, Joseph was sold to Egypt and bought by a person by the name of Potiphar, who allowed Joseph to be a slave within his household.
我们看创世纪的第三十九章，看
第二节 ，Chapter 39, verse 2. The Lord was
with 神跟约瑟同在，就让他百事顺利。
And verse 2, the Lord was with Joseph and he was successful. He was a successful man.
我们看看第三节，他的主人见到神跟他同在，又看到神让他手里所办的事情都非常的顺利。
Verse 3, and his master saw that the Lord was with him and that the Lord made all he did to prosper in his hand.
我们看第五节。
Also in verse 5.
这样子神就因为约瑟的缘故，似乎给那埃及人的家，凡是家里跟田间一切所有的，都蒙到神的祝福。
That the Lord blessed the Egyptians' household for Joseph's sake, and the blessing of the Lord was on all that he had in the house and in the field.
从这段圣经我们知道，约瑟在人家家里当奴隶的时候，他是奴隶的头，只有主人比他的权力更大。
We can see that how when Joseph was a slave within that household, he was promoted to such a position that he was only lower than the master within the house.
从这段圣经，我们也看到神跟约瑟同在，同时也让埃及的主人看到神的作为。
We can see how God was with Joseph and that the Egyptians was able to see God's deeds from Joseph.
但是约瑟在主人的家里又遭到第二次的灾难。
However, Joseph actually encountered the second difficult tribulation disaster within this household.
因为主人的妻子要诱惑他，然后最后把他陷害了，让他 关在监狱里面。
Because Master's wife wanted to frame Joseph and accuse him, so that Joseph was later on become jailed.
男人被女人引诱是一个大的灾难。
When men were to be seduced by women, it would be a great disaster.
像所罗门王往年的时候被许多妃嫔诱惑去祭拜外邦神，因此就被神弃绝了。
For example, King Solomon was seduced by many of his concubines, such that he was then forsaken by the Lord.
士师参孙被一个女人大力拉诱惑陷害而丧失了生命。
One of the judges, Samson, actually was framed by a woman by the name of Delilah, and to the point where he lost his life.
约瑟对主人非常的尽忠，所以他拒绝主人妻子的诱惑。
Joseph was very loyal to his master, and therefore he refused the seduction from his master's wife.
他对他说，我怎能做这个大恶来得罪神呢？
Joseph said, how can I commit such great evil deed to offend the Lord?
这让我们看到约瑟虽然是奴隶，但是神一直在他的心中。
We can see how even though Joseph was a slave, but then God remained within his heart.
但是这个主人的妻子不断地来诱惑他。有一次主人的妻子拉住了约瑟的衣服，约瑟丢下了衣服就跑到外面去了。
Nonetheless, the master's wife continued to try to seduce Joseph. That one time when they were alone, the master's wife was able to get a hold of Joseph's clothes and was able to hold on to it, but Joseph had to escape without the clothes.
这个女人就拿着这件衣服向她的丈夫诬告约瑟要戏弄她，所以这样子约瑟就被主人关在监狱里了。
And by having this clothes, the master's wife was able to falsely accuse Joseph of trying to commit sexual acts against the wife, and the master then later on put Joseph in jail.
我们看创世纪三十九章的第二十一节，在监狱里面，神跟约瑟同在，将他施恩，使他在失业的眼前蒙恩。
In Genesis chapter 39, verse 21, there, but the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy, and he gave him favor.
我们看第二十二节
，verse 22。
失业就将所有的囚犯都交在约瑟的手下，让他来管理。
And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hands all the prisoners who were in the prison. Whatever they did, there it was his doing.
我们再看第二十三节，神跟约瑟同在，神使约瑟所做的事情都尽顺利。
Because the Lord was with him, and whatever he did, the Lord made it prosper.
所以我们看到约瑟在监狱里面也变成只有在一个人之下，然后但是还是被关在监狱里。
So we can see how when Joseph was in prison, he was still made in a position where he was only lower than the master of the prison.
在监狱中，神赐给约瑟有解梦的能力。
And while in prison, God bestowed upon Joseph this ability of being able to interpret dreams.
我们看创世纪的第四十章第八节。
Genesis chapter 40, verse 8.
这边讲说约瑟为法老的两个官员来解梦。
Here mention how Joseph interpreted dreams for two of the officials from Pharaoh.
因为这两个官员被 法老关在监狱里面。
That is, these two pharaohs were actually put in jail by, these two officials were put in jail by the pharaoh.
也是对他们说，解梦是出于神，所以也是将自己的能力都归功给神。
Joseph mentioned that this ability to be able to interpret dream came from the Lord, and therefore he said everything would come from the Lord.
也是为他们解梦，所有的梦完全的正确，所以三天以后，这两个人就离开了监狱。
And the way that Joseph interpreted dreams for them were quite accurate, and therefore after 3 days, these two individuals departed from the prison.
但是这一个久正的，他出去了监狱以后，就忘记了约瑟，所以约瑟又被关在监狱里面两年。
Nonetheless, this chief butler, whose dream was interpreted, forgot about Joseph, and that is why Joseph remained in prison for 3 more years.
一直等到两年以后，法老做了两个梦，所有埃及的术士、博士都没有人能够为法老解梦。
So after 2 years, Pharaoh had a dream that none of the wise men within the land of Egypt was able to interpret this dream.
这个时候，这个酒正突然想起约瑟有解梦的能力，所以就去告诉法老。
Later on, this chief butler reminded himself of Joseph's ability to interpret dreams, and then he made mention to Pharaoh.
所以法老就将约瑟从监狱里面提出来。
Pharaoh then brought Joseph out of the prison.
我们看创世纪的第41章第16节。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 41, verse 6.
第16节。
Verse 16.
这个时候约瑟对法老说，解梦不在乎我，神必定将平安的话来回答法老。
Verse 16. So Joseph answered Pharaoh, saying, "It is not in me. God will give Pharaoh an answer of peace."
所以我们在这里又看出约瑟敬畏神，尊神为大，归一切的荣耀给天上的神。
At this point, we realize that Joseph still respected the Lord, and he said that everything came from the Lord.
所以约瑟就把法老的梦解释给法老听。
Therefore, Joseph was able to interpret the Pharaoh's dreams for Pharaoh.
我们看创世纪的第41章25节。
Turn to Genesis chapter 41, verse 25.
约瑟对法老说，法老的梦只是一个，因为神已经将所要做的事情显明给法老。
And Joseph said to Pharaoh, "The dreams of Pharaoh are one. God has shown Pharaoh what he is about to do."
我们看第29节
，verse 29.
埃及遍地必定有七个大丰年。第30节
，verse 30.
以随后又要来个七个方年。
And after that, 7 years of famine will arise.
那我们来看第32节。
Turn to verse 32.
约瑟对法老说，法老这两回做梦是因为神命定这件事情，而且必速速的成就。
And the dream was repeated to Pharaoh twice because the thing is established by God, and God will shortly bring it to pass.
我们看第33节。
Turn to verse 33.
所以法老应当拣选一个有聪明、有智慧的人，派领他治理整个埃及地。
Now therefore, let Pharaoh select a discerning and wise man and set him over the land of Egypt.
法老非常喜欢约瑟的解梦跟建议， 所以就指定约瑟来管理整个埃及。
Pharaoh really liked Joseph's interpretation as well as his advice, and therefore Joseph was made to manage the entire land of Egypt.
我们看创世纪的41章38节。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 41, verse 38.
法老对他臣仆说，像这样的人有神的灵在他里头，我们岂能找得着呢？
And Pharaoh said to his servants, "Can we find such a one as this, a man in whom is the Spirit of God?"
39节
Verse 39.
法老对约瑟说，神即将这个事情都指示你，可见没有人像你这样有聪明有智慧。
And Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Inasmuch as God has shown you all this, there is no one as discerning and wise as you."
40节
Verse 40.
你可以掌管我的家，我的民必都听从你的话。唯有独在宝座上的我比你还大。
You shall be over my house, and all my people shall be ruled according to your word. Only in regard to the throne will I be greater than you.
所以从这段我们看到法老看到神的作为在约瑟的身上，所以提升他为埃及的首相。
And so from here we can see how Pharaoh was able to witness God's miraculous deeds in Joseph. Therefore, Pharaoh made Joseph to be the prime minister of the land of Egypt.
在这里，约瑟只有在法老一人之下，神使他非常的昌盛。
And here we can see how Joseph was.Promoted to a position that he is only lower than than Pharaoh, and he was made prosper because of this.
最后，以色列的全家因为饥荒，都住到埃及，得到约瑟的救助。
And because of this, during this famine, Joseph's entire family was able to move to the land of Egypt and become safe.By Joseph.
我们看创世纪第五十章第二十节。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 50.
第二十节。
Verse 20.
在这个时候，约瑟对哥哥们说：“从前你们的意思是要害我，但是神的意思原是好的，要保全许多人的性命。”成就今日的光景。
Verse 20, but as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day to save many people alive.
我们看第二十一节。
Turn to verse 21.
现在你们不要害怕，我必养活你们和你们的妇人孩子。于是约瑟用亲爱的话安慰他们。
21. Now therefore do not be afraid. I will provide for you and your little ones. And he comforted them and spoke kindly to them.
所以从创世纪这个故事，我们知道神预先安排约瑟到埃及，让他经历许多的苦难，最后成为宰相。
Therefore from the story we realize that God had arranged Joseph to go to Egypt first and suffer a great deal.But later on was able to save his family.
约瑟在这十三年的苦难中，因为他心中有神，他依靠神，所以神与他同在，使他昌盛。
In this 13 years of difficulties, adversities, Joseph had God in him still, and therefore God made him prosperous.
他救了以色列的全家。以色列十二个支派才能够存活在埃及四百年。
Joseph was able to save the entire household of Jacob, and such that the 12 tribes of Israel was able to live within the land of Egypt.
约瑟成就了神的救赎的计划。
God was able to accomplish the plan of salvation through Joseph.
所以 我们在苦难中要学习约瑟，他心中有神，他依靠神，所以神一定会跟我们同在，神也会让我们在苦难以后能够得到昌盛。
So we must learn to be like Joseph, such that we have God in us and relying on the Lord, so that later on, after the adversity pass away, we shall be safe by the Lord.
再来，我们来看看另外圣经的一个故事，就是拿俄米跟路德回转归向神，神让他们离开苦难而得到昌盛。
Let us also read another biblical story that is Naomi and Ruth, how they turned back to the Lord and was later on saved.
我们看路德记第一章，那边就记载。
In Ruth chapter 1 recorded this.
Naomi 跟她的丈夫以利米勒以及两个儿子，因为犹大地遇到饥荒，所以他们就搬到摩亚地去聚居。
We can see that Ruth and along with her husband Elimelech, with their two sons, due to famine within the land of Israel, they moved to the land of Moab.
这是这个家庭遭到苦难的开始。
This was the beginning of the adversity for this entire family.
因为聚集在外邦的地方是一个困难的环境。
Because living in foreign land would be a very difficult situation.
他们总共在摩亚地住了约有十年，然后拿俄米的丈夫死了，两个儿子也都死了。
In the land of Moab, they lived there for about 10 years, but within that time, the husband passed away, and then subsequently, the two sons also passed away.
这时候，全家只剩下三位寡妇，就是拿俄米以及两个媳妇。
And within the entire household, only three women remain, that is Naomi, along with the two daughter-in-laws.
这个家庭的处境真的是非常的可怜。
It became very tragic for this entire family.
我们看路德记第一章的第六节。
Let's turn to Ruth chapter 1, verse 6.
这个时候，拿俄米听到在犹大地神眷顾百姓，是粮食给他们，所以他和两个儿妇要回到犹大地去了。
Then she arose with her daughters-in-law that she might return from the country of Moab, for she had heard in the country of Moab that the Lord had visited his people by giving them bread.
拿俄米在这种悲惨的情况下，他想到神，所以决定要回归到神的国度，要投靠真神，这是生命的转捩点。
In such a pitiful situation, Naomi reminded herself of the Lord, such that she was willing to return back to the kingdom of God, and so that became a turning point in their lives.
他们在离开的时候，拿俄米要求两个媳妇各自回娘家，另外嫁给新的丈夫，得到平安。
Before their departure, Naomi requested the two daughters-in-law to go back to their homeland so that they can find new husbands to marry.
他们这三个寡妇就拥抱哭泣，舍不得来分开。
And for these three widows, they hugged each other, but then they did not want to depart away from each other.
但是最后大媳妇就离开了，最小的媳妇路德坚持要跟随着伯婆一起回伯利恒。
The older daughter-in-law departed from them, But then the younger daughter-in-law insisted on returning back to Bethlehem with Naomi.
我们看看路德记第一章的第十六节。
Let's turn to Ruth chapter 1, verse 16.
路德作为婆婆说，不要催我回去，不跟随你。你往哪里去，我也往那里去。你在哪里住，我也在那里住宿。你的国就是我的国，你的神就是我的神。
Verse 16, but Ruth said, entreat me not to leave you, or to turn back from following after you. For wherever you go, I will go. And wherever you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God.
第十七节。
Verse
17. 你在哪里死，我在那里死，也葬在那里，除非死能使你我相离。不然愿神重重地降罚于我。
Verse 17, where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me, and more also, if anything but death parts you and me.
由这段话，我们可以看得出路德对她婆婆的孝顺，生死不离开，并且定义要跟婆婆一同来投靠天上的真神。
At this point, we can see how much love Ruth had toward her mother-in-law, Naomi, such that she was willing to follow her anywhere.
路德跟拿欧米就回到伯利恒以后，路德就在波阿斯的田里捡掉下来的麦穗来过日子。
And after they returned together to Bethlehem,Ruth then worked to pick up the grains from Boaz's field to make a living.
我们看路德记第二章的第十一节。
Let's turn to Ruth chapter 2.
十一节。
Verse 11.
波阿斯对路德说，自从你丈夫死后，管你向婆婆所行的。并且你离开父母和本地，到素不认识的民中，这些事人都全部告诉我了。
Verse 11, and Boaz answered and said to her, It has been fully reported to me that all you have done for your mother-in-law since the death of your husband, and how you have left your father and your mother and the land of your birth, and have come to a people whom you did not know before.
第十二节。
Verse 12.
愿神照你所行的赏赐你，你来投靠耶和华以色列神的翅膀下，愿你满得他的赏赐。
Verse 12, and the Lord repay your work, and a full reward be given you by the Lord God of Israel, under whose wings you have come for refuge.
拿俄米对路德也是非常的关心，也很爱他。所以就为她找了一个可以依靠的丈夫。
Naomi really cared about Ruth, and therefore Naomi tried to find a caring husband for Ruth.
波阿斯刚好是他们同族的亲戚，所以最后波阿斯就娶了路德为妻，同时又生了一个儿子。
Boaz happened to be their one of their family members, and therefore.Boaz was able to marry Ruth. Later on, they also had another child.
我们来看看拿欧米跟路德最后得到神怎么样祝福给他们得到昌盛。
And so let us examine how later on for Naomi and Ruth, how God made them prosper.
我们看路德记的第四章第十四节。
Let's turn to Ruth chapter 4, verse 14.
妇人对拿欧米说，耶和华是应当称颂的，因为今日没有撇下了你，使你无没有至近的亲属，愿这个孩子在以色列中得名声。
Verse 14, then the woman said to Naomi, Blessed be the Lord, who has not left you to this day without a close relative, and may his name be famous in Israel.
第十五节
Verse 15.
他必提起你的精神，奉养你的劳，因为是爱慕你的那个儿妇所生的。有这个儿妇，比有七个儿子还好。
Verse 15. And may he be to you a restorer of life and a nourisher of your old age, for your daughter-in-law, who loves you, who is better to you than seven sons, has borne him.
第十六节
Verse 16.
拿俄米就把孩子抱在怀里做他的养母。
Then Naomi took the child and laid him on her bosom and became a nurse to him.
第十七节
Verse 17.
邻舍的妇人说，拿俄米得了孩子了，就给他起名叫厄贝德。这个厄贝德是耶西的父，耶西是大卫的父。
Verse 17, also the neighbor woman gave him a name, saying, there is a son born to Naomi, and they call his name Obed. He is the father of Jesse, the father of David.
拿俄米跟路德从无依无靠的苦难中，他们回归向神，回到神所眷顾的地方，投靠神，所以让他们得到昌盛，并且得到安慰。
Naomi and Ruth returned back to the land that God has shown his favor, and therefore, they were able to be saved and made prosper in the time of adversity.
使原本已经没落的家庭得以复兴起来。
So a declining household can later on may prosper.
并且因为路德所行出来的美德，他也得到了神跟人的赞美以及祝福。
And because of the great deeds done by Ruth, she was later on able to receive praise from others.
这个家成为伟大君王大卫的先祖。
And then this family later on became the ancestral home for great King David.
以后耶稣诞生在这个家族，他们完成了神的救赎计划。
Subsequently, Lord Jesus was born to this line of family, then the salvation was able to be completed by them.
这让我们看到回归转向神是何等的重要。
So we can see how returning back to face the Lord, to be in Lord's presence, becomes so important.
我们的神是有恩典、施怜悯的神。
God is a God of grace with great mercy.
我们如果转向他，他必不转脸不顾的。
If we return back to face him, he will not forsake us and leave us.
因为神赏赐寻求他的人。
Because God will reward those who pray to him.
所以在患难中我们要归回神，要听从他的话。
That is why in the midst of adversities, we need to return back to him as well as listen to his words.
在新约圣经里面，浪子回头也是从苦难中然后得到父亲的接纳，也是一个很值得我们学习的故事。
In the New Testament, we saw how the prodigal son returned back to the father after adversity. He then remained a good example for us to learn from.
这记载在路加福音的第十五章。
This was recorded in Luke chapter 15.
这个小儿子拿到父亲的财产，就到远方去了，把所有的财产都浪费掉了。
Upon obtaining his father's possessions, the son actually went to land far away and later on wasted all that possessions.
这个时候，他一无所有，碰到了大饥荒。
at that time, he became broke, but then he encountered a great famine.
他的苦难就开始了。
That was the time when his period of adversity began.
我们来看路加福音的第十五章十四节到第十六节。
Let's turn to Luke chapter 15 from verse 14 to verse 15.
请读第十四节。
Verse 14. But when he had spent all, there arose severe famine in the land, and he began to be in want.
第十五节。
Verse 15. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine.
第十六节。
Verse 16, and he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pots that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything.
所以我们就看到这个浪子想要依靠一个人，但是这个人安排他去养猪，猪是犹太人看为不洁净的动物。
See how when he wanted to rely on a particular person, but then that person sent him to go look after these swines, swines would actually be animals that would be considered unclean to the Jews.
再来，没有人给他食物吃，所以他巴不得想要吃喂猪的豆荚来充饥。
And since no one gave him food to eat, and that's why he really wanted to fill his stomach with the pots that the swine ate.
这个时候他醒悟过来了，他想到父亲的家有多么好，有许多的工人，又有许多的粮食。
At that time, he then woke up and realized that in his father's household, there remained a lot of food as well as workers.
所以他决定要向回家，向父亲悔改，说我得罪了天，也得罪了你，我不配得做你的儿子，把我当作一个雇工好了。
Therefore, he said that, I have sinned against you as well as sinned against, the heaven, and therefore, I will not be worthy to be called your son, but then today, consider me to be one of the workers.
我们看第十五章的第二十节。
Let's turn to Luke chapter 15, verse 20.
他的父亲远远的看到他，就跑去抱着他，一直的跟他亲嘴。
Verse 20, and he arose and came to his father, but when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him.
我们看第二十二节。
Let's turn to verse 22.
这个父亲为儿子穿上最好的衣袍，戴上戒指，穿上鞋子。
And then, for the son, the father brought out the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and sandals on his feet.
我们看第二十三节。
Verse 23.
Yeah, 二十三节。
And bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry.
所以他们宰了牛犊，就那边吃喝快乐起来的。我们看第二十四节
，verse 24。
所以父亲对大家宣告说：“我这个儿子是死而复活、失而复得的，所以我们就要快乐起来。”
And so the father said that the son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found, and he began to be merry.
所以浪子在苦难中想到天父的家，然后就回去了。我们可以看到这个浪子回到家里就成为宝贝的儿子了。
You can see how when the son was reminded of how wonderful his father's house was, he then returned, and you can see how merry they were after his return.
所以当我们离开神，
So after
you, 要知道能够回归向神。
After we departed from God and came under adversity, then we need to learn how to return back to God.
在新约里面，使徒保罗他一直以得到耶稣基督为他人生的目标。
And so in the New Testament, we saw how Apostle Paul treated obtaining the Lord as his life goal.
在新约圣经里面有27卷，其中保罗的书信就有13卷。
Now, within the New Testament, there exist 27 books, and then Paul wrote 13 of them.
他将耶稣的福音传给非犹太的外邦人。
He was able to preach the gospel unto those who are not Jews.
使徒保罗，他的工作影响了世界上所有的基督徒。
The work of Apostle Paul came to influence all the Christians of this world.
我们现在所读的保罗书信，大约在2000年前保罗所写的。
And so the epistles that we are reading today would be those written by Paul 2,000 years ago.
在《使徒行传》第九章那边记载，主耶稣用大光照着保罗来开始呼召他。
And so in the book of Acts, we can see how the Lord used great light to shine upon Paul so that he had change of heart.
在第三节到第五节那边就记载，
In verse 3 to verse 5, there it then recorded.
Please read.
Verse 3, as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven. Verse 4, then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Verse 5, and he said, Who are you, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. It is hard for you to kick against the goats.
当保罗被亚拿尼亚按手医治了以后，他就开始发起热心，来放胆向犹太人证明耶稣就是基督。
After Paul was healed, after being laid hand upon by Ananias,He then went to preach to the Jews that Lord Jesus would be the Savior.
那个时候，保罗就开始遭受到苦难，因为很多犹太人就设法要来把他杀死。
But then that was a time when Paul had to suffer from adversity because all the Jews plotted to kill Paul.
我们看《使徒行传》第九章。
Turn to Acts chapter 9,
22节到23节
to 23. Verse 22, but Saul increased all the more in strength and confounded the Jews who dwelt in Damascus, proving that Jesus is the Christ. Verse 23. Now, after many days were passed, the Jews plotted to kill him.
我们看29节
Turn to verse 29.
Please read.
And he spoke boldly in the name of the Lord Jesus and disputed against the Hellenists, but they attempted to kill him.
所以保罗开始为了传福音，开始遭受到很生命的威胁。
So in preaching the gospel, Paul encountered these dangerous plots against his life.
我们来看保罗怎么样来回顾他所遭遇的苦难
？So let us examine how Paul reflected upon the adversities that he suffered from.
我们看哥林多后书第十一章。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 11,
23节到29节。
From verse 23 to verse 29.
因为时间的关系，所以我们不必读。但是从这一段我们知道保罗多次被关在监牢里多次被鞭打 而且遭受到许多死亡的危险。
And so from this passage, we realize that Paul had been beaten many times and jailed many times, and then was in the brink of his of losing his life many times.
除了这外在的苦难，保罗在肉体上也有一根刺。他三次祈求神将这根刺拿走，神没有答应。
And then also Paul had this thorn that he prayed to God to remove from him, but then God did not want to refuse his request.
但是使徒保罗将所受到的苦难提升成为属灵的力量，将苦难当成是可喜乐的事情。
But then Paul considered the adversities to be something that he can cherish.
因为他认为配得为耶稣基督受苦是一个荣耀。
Because he considered it to be glorious to be worthy to suffer for the Lord.
使徒保罗以认识耶稣基督为最宝贵。
Apostle Paul considered knowing Lord Jesus to be the most precious.
在腓立比书上面，保罗说，他在监狱的时候，他写，他将万事当作有损，以认识耶稣基督为至宝。
In Philippians, Paul said that he considered everything to be refuse, but the knowledge of Lord Jesus Christ to be the most precious.
保罗书信许多是在监狱里面受困难的时候写下来的。
And so the epistles from Paul were written in the, within the circumstances of being in prison and under times of difficulty.
他更勉励所有的信徒靠主要常常喜乐。
He also encouraged all the members to become joyful by relying on the Lord.
所以我们来看保罗怎么样叙述他的一生。
And so let us lastly read how Paul described his life.
我们看提摩太后书的第四章。
2 Timothy chapter 4.
第七节。
2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 7.
那美好的仗我已经打过了，当跑的路我已经跑尽了，所信的道我已经守住了。
Chapter 4 verse 7. I have fought a good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith.
第八节。
Verse 8.
有公义的冠冕为我存留，就是按着公义审判的主，到了那日要赐给我的，不但赐给我，也要赐给凡是爱慕他显现的人。
Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, not to me only, but also to all who have loved his appearing.
所以无论我们在世界上面临什么样的苦难，我们总是要依靠神，以得到耶稣为最宝贵的目标。
And so regardless of what we encounter, we should treat obtaining Lord Jesus as the most precious goal.
这样我们也可以如同保罗一样的从神那里得到在天上的昌盛。
And so that just like Paul, we shall also receive that prosperity in God.
得到永生的冠冕。
And we obtain that everlasting crown.
在苦难中神让我们得昌盛，虽然在属世上的昌盛是短暂的。
Even though God allows us to be prosperous, and this kind of physical prosperity might be short-lived.
但是神所赐给我们的昌盛是要带领我们一同走在神的救赎道路上。
But then this kind of spiritual prosperity shall allow us to continue to walk on the path that the Lord had designated for us.
晚上分享到此，我们一起来唱诗151首。
This is the end of my sharing, so let us sing hymn number 151.
好，现在跪下来做最后的祷告。
Right now, we shall all kneel down and pray together.
在祷告里面，我们彼此代祷，尤其为那些在这个时候发生很多苦难的弟兄姐妹们祷告，让求让神在这段时间能够让他们得到安慰。
So during our prayer, let us pray for one another so that in this time when people have difficulties, God can help them.
然后我们祷告神，神是我们的依靠，所以不管怎么样，我们就一直要来信靠他。
And so that in this time, regardless of what the circumstance would be, we can come to rely on him.
我们跪下祷告十分钟，我会
邀你。Kneel down and pray together for 10 minutes, I will ring the bell.